maybe chasing a dream ultimately leads you back home. At least I think that's true for Hailey Whitters and her beautiful new album, Raised. Lots of albums are great. This is great and really beautiful. Sonically, I think it's really beautiful. So I feel like it is this 47-minute long walk around in someone else's shoes, and it's very detailed and it's very vibrant. So I'm curious, like, how did you learn to be that kind of an observer?
I kind of feel like that's our job as songwriters, is to be professional people watchers, you know, to just like observe and pick up on the detail and notice the detail and, you know, the things that maybe the average person might not notice, that it's kind of our job to pick up on that and to find a way to put it in song and make people, you know, maybe stop and think about something that they otherwise wouldn't have thought about. So I don't know. I mean, I guess just probably as like a listener, like that's the stuff that interests me in music, you know, is when I can really turn on a song and feel like I'm there, you know, just based on the lyrics and stuff like that.
Did you have to kind of like go away to be able to have this kind of perspective on your home and your hometown?
You know, I think I probably did. I feel like when I was 17, I just couldn't get out of there soon enough. You know, I was already, my head was totally in Nashville. I was moving there. I was going to be in country music. I was getting out. You know, it's weird because I always knew I was going to go back. Like I had this plan to leave. And by the time I was 25, I'd have been so successful that I'd be able to move back and do country music from Iowa, you know? And that just goes to show how completely disillusioned I was with what it takes to make it in country music. But, you know, I think that having left, it allowed me the perspective to see it a little more and appreciate it a lot more than had I just stayed there the whole time. You know, I don't know if I would have had the foresight to be able to kind of see how special that place was to me, is to me.
I love how vulnerable you are about what it's like when it gets hard. And I think that maybe the most encouraging thing like we can do for the people that come after us is be honest about the fact that it is going to get hard and there might still be something great on the other side. But I don't know if I had known that you had been waitressing at Richard's.
Yeah.
And like kind of were not like you were not like, which is like a place where, you know, you'd played and it's like writer's rounds. And if people don't know, it's a sweet, really cute vibe in there. And I'm, you know, I was thinking in my, for myself, there was like a moment where I like looked around and I was like, I might have peaked and like, it didn't happen. I might be looking back on the most successful moment of my career so far and going out and being around people in the industry, I felt more awkward and self-conscious than maybe I had in years because when you're on the climb, it's like everybody knows you're up and coming, you're coming, but like when you stall a little bit or you're not, it's like that was for me when I've like sat with my stuff and been like, oh, wait. So was that happening for you at all when you were like waiting on people? Like, was that humbling or like you're waiting on people that are doing the thing that you can do and you know you can do it, but you're like not sure it's going to work out?
Yeah, I mean, so I have a story of work like waitressing at Richard's and John Party walked in and I like it was the moment where like you see him walk in the door and I was like, okay, I'm gonna go hide in the back until he's left, you know what I mean, where it's like your gut instinct is like, because I had just like opened shows for him 3 years before, you know what I mean, I'm his opening act, we're playing sold out shows, and you know, I was just kind of like, I guess I was just kind of like embarrassed, you know, I was like, man, I don't want to have to like go up and ask him, like, you know, ask him if I can get it. It just felt so weird to have to like wait on someone that you were like working with, you know what I mean? And I felt kind of weird about it. And I just went up to him and said, hey, what's up? And it was really awkward for a second. I could see the look on like, you know, him and his manager's face, like, hey, what are you doing here? You know what I mean? And I'm like, I'm working. And it was kind of awkward, but then also, you know, it's like, there's no shame in working hard and doing whatever you gotta do to pay your bills so that you can keep your dream alive, you know? And I just think, like, I mean, it kind of makes me weepy talking about it because, you know, there's absolutely no shame in that. And I'm embarrassed now that I felt embarrassed by it then, because, you know, it's like, I think that that's admirable. And if it weren't me and I saw someone else doing that, I'd be like, you're badass. Like, that's awesome.
If we were going to talk songs, one that I felt like I was like, I have tried to write College Town, that idea and that title, on multiple occasions, and you got it. Like, I was so, it was like, yes.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that so much. I mean, I remember, like, Nicole Galleon had that title. And to me, like, I did move. I mean, I moved down here when I was 17, and I was moving down here no matter what. But my parents, they never went to college. They were pretty adamant about the fact that if I were moving 9 hours away, I mean, I am this very naive, very impressionable, young blonde girl, you know, I like had nothing. And to move so far away, I think they were really scared for me. So they were very adamant about me going to college. And I remember, like, you know, I'm very proud and very appreciative of my education. But I remember, like, thinking, like, going to college wasn't that cool. You know what I mean? Like, I wanted to go straight into songwriting and, like, be a writer and be an artist and all that. I remember, like, going home a few times and just, like, you know, thinking my parents were just, like, so old-fashioned and, like, had these ideas and beliefs and, like, that's not the way the world works. You guys don't know, blah, 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 you know? And so I was that girl in that second verse, and it kind of makes me chuckle now. And it's, like, you know, it makes me cringe a little bit, too, but it's also just, like, I just think that, you know, especially like that going to college and stuff, that's been such a thing in like our generation and everything. And I just think that, you know, there's so many more things that you learn that aren't in the textbook, you know, and I think that having those 4 years to kind of really figure out who you are is a really good thing to be able to get the opportunity to do.
I think a lot of people are going to connect to that on a lot of levels. What is the most vulnerable Hailey moment?
I think the most vulnerable, like, I don't know if it's like a Hailey thing, but like definitely the most vulnerable moment. And I guess it is kind of like a Hailey thing, because I'm kind of like, I guess, singing the song and like saying it at the time, but is probably Pretty Boy. Like, I think Pretty Boy is, you know, a very vulnerable topic, and it's kind of ironic because it's basically trying to tell, you know, a lot of the boys that I grew up with, like, it's cool to be vulnerable, it's strong to be vulnerable. So yeah, I mean, I just feel like that song on the record, I'm really excited, I'm anxious, I am nervous for people to hear it, because I do think it's just something that, like, you know, I feel like I haven't really heard anyone say, and could be something that, you know, people are either going to hate it or love it. But I wrote that song, you know, about some of the boys that I know from my town and some of the things that I've seen. And I just want them to know that, you know, it's cool to be vulnerable. It's cool to show people who you are. It's cool to express yourself, to say I love you, to tell someone you love them. Yeah, I've seen ways in which I think suppressing a lot of those emotions can really be damaging to a boy. And so I want them to know, like, it's cool to do that, you know?